Pacemakers and defibrillators are potentially life-saving medical therapies. However, there's a high rate of device malfunction and device recall. Defibrillators can provide potentially life-saving therapies by shocking patients out of potentially fatal rhythms. However, they can also inappropriately shock patients, which can cause harm by causing pain to the patient and also by causing the heart function to potentially decrease as well. Therefore, I think it's extremely important that we try to find ways to minimize inappropriate therapies such that our devices are safer.
Clinical trials are the established method for evaluating the safety and efficacy of medical devices. However, clinical trials can take anywhere between 2 and 6 years to complete at a cost of $10 to $20 million. Our team has developed a simulation-based methodology for preclinical trials. We believe that a simulation-based preclinical trial can be completed within a week and at a fraction of the cost.
An in silico preclinical trial proceeds in 4 steps. First, we obtain the distributions for key model parameters from real patient data. This way, the results of our synthetic trial approximate the results that would be obtained from our real clinical trial on those real patients. For each patient in our database, we calculate the values of key parameters. We will use these parameter values when generating the synthetic group of patients. By fitting a distribution to the extracted parameter values, we can sample the distribution and generate synthetic patients. Each heart model represents a patient with one disease or condition. We simulate this heart model to obtain the electrograms or heart signals. Finally, we feed these electrograms to the devices and calculate their performance. Now we'll demonstrate how to run an in silico preclinical trial with our toolchain. An in silico preclinical trial consists of 5 different steps. In the first step, real patient data needs to be processed to identify clinical conditions and device interactions. After importing a patient record containing recorded electrogram signals, the raw data signals are manually adjudicated by clinicians and automatically filtered to remove noise artifacts and then labeled. Within a record, the different patient conditions, known as arrhythmias, are annotated to extract patient signatures. These signatures are used as a template for generating new virtual signals in the next phase of the in silico preclinical trial. After the different signatures for a condition have been extracted, the next step of the in silico trial is to generate a population of heart models with different clinical conditions. To generate a range of signals for a specific heart condition, different parameter ranges and variances can be set for the condition. Once the signals have been viewed and approved for the in silico trial, they are added to the virtual cohort. Let's proceed to the simulated trial. To evaluate the performance of the device, the trial can be run on a range of implantable cardiac devices with different device settings. The simulation is executed for each virtual patient. In this example, our toolchain displays the progress of the simulation for a 2-patient cohort. A result summary at the end of the simulation highlights the simulated trial results. In addition to device simulation, in silico trials support testing with the device in the loop. At this stage, the user can feed a real device with the signals from the virtual cohort. The synthetic signals are then fed to the real device through a data acquisition system, which can report whether a shock event occurs. You can observe the signals fed to the device through the toolchain on the device programmer. Now a shock therapy has been delivered and successfully acquired. The results of the in silico trials from simulation and device-in-the-loop testing are viewed in the final step of the toolchain. Statistics, such as device sensitivity and specificity, are summarized and displayed as a table and a graph. The results can be exported for further analysis and for filing as regulatory-grade evidence. We have shown the potential for our toolchain to perform in silico clinical trials. Our toolchain addresses the need for reducing the costs for clinical trials and improving the safety and reliability of new medical devices. We have created a model-based methodology which allows for simulation of a clinical trial over a virtual cohort and also tests actual medical devices. Our team is collaborating with physicians and specialists from the University of Pennsylvania Hospital, as well as with regulatory authorities such as the FDA to further develop our toolchain. The in silico preclinical trial methodology presented here is being actively explored with the US FDA as a new approach to regulatory-grade evidence.